When the vicious Honored Matres returned out of the scattering, 1500 years after the fall of the Worm God's empire, they intended to dominate all. They brought many different weapons and technologies with them, including Futars. The Futars were enslaved. The Honored Matres treated the Futar creatures as if they were pets. Futars had a limited capacity for language, and their intelligence was somewhat below human level. The Futars had originally been created in the scattering by the enemy of the Matres, the ones of many faces, who likely are related to the members of the tleilaxu who had originally gone into the scattering. The Futars had originally been created as a weapon against the Honored Matres. They were a tool that could hunt down and eliminate the Matres. Amongst the stars, the two groups had fought a long and bloody war. It is implied that the technology used to create the Futars may have been used to create other genetically modified humans. There is evidence that the Honored Matres intended to bring an amphibian humanoid slave race to the planet Buzzle. In appearance, the Futars look mostly human, but with what the book Chapter House Dune describes as an unmistakable ferocity. The Bene Gesserit surmised that they must have been the result of genetic manipulation involving humans and felines. The Honored Matres even sometimes fed the Futars with human flesh, though the creatures do not seem savage by nature. The Honored Matres knew Futars would not breed in captivity, but captivity also revealed the fact that the humanoid creatures were vulnerable. Since the Futars had limited mental capacity, they could only speak an abbreviated language. In seconds, she was dead. Servants carried the body away. It would be fed to captive Futars. Not that Futars were much use, wouldn't breed in captivity, wouldn't obey the most ordinary commands, sullen, waiting. Where handlers, one might ask, or other useless words would spill from their humanoid mouths. Still, Futars provided some pleasures. The Honored Matres could bend the Futars to their will in several ways, but the Futars could not be controlled through sex, as was the speciality of the Honored Matres. The Futars hated the Matres, and they and their mysterious handlers eventually aid the Bene Gesserit in their struggle against the Matres sisters. The handlers did not control the Futars through aggression or fear. There seemed to be some intentionally bred biological dependency. The Futars obeyed the commands of the handlers but did not resent them. Both the handlers and the Futars mutually respected each other. It is suggested that these handlers could be at the center of the mysterious circumstances that had sent the Honored Matres fleeing back into the old empire. And the ones of many faces, cursed them through eternity, had caused this disaster. Them and their Futars. The ease with which all but a handful of the weapon had been confiscated. Awesome powers. We must arm ourselves well before we return to that battle. It is clear that the Honored Matres have returned to the old empire to bide their time and prepare for their eventual return into the scattering to face the threat that they feared so greatly. The exact connections between the ones of many faces, the handlers, and the Futars, and the Honored Matres remains unclear in the original saga. Who can say what the tleilaxu, free from watchful eyes, may have developed in the scattering? It is suggested in the book Chapter House Dune, as well, that the Honored Matres may fear a biological weapon, and it is possible that the handlers themselves could be the source.